In this video, we will understand about rapid detection technology and we will answer these questions after understanding this video. First question is, what is ELISA method? How does it work? Describe various steps in a PCR cycle. Describe the principle and working of flow cytometry. How does impedance technique function? Give names of instrument available for its commercial application as a rapid method for detection of bacteria. Describe the functioning of biosensors and rapid detection methods have the potential of ushering in a new era of real-time microbiology. Give your comments. So all these questions we can answer. Okay. So there is a need for rapid detection technique because in conventional methods, the detection process is very lengthy, and to find out the real culprit, if we take more time, then the effort is not useful. That's why there is a need of accurate identification of the cause of foodborne illness. And this is also required because we cannot completely remove all the pathogens from the food supply, because there is a chances of contamination from the food handlers, or there is a chance of lapses in hygiene or sanitation practices. The methods for rapid detections of foodborne microorganisms, both spoilage and pathogens, are classified into biochemical, where we use some chemicals to identify the foodborne microorganisms. In some immunological, within that we use some antibodies, and genetic approaches where we do some gene amplifications, or where we do use some PCR technology. But some methods are also there which applies more than one technology: biochemical plus genetic approach, or genetic approach plus immunological, like those things. This additional test which confirms the presence of Salmonella or any other microbiological agents are done by the help of pattern utilizations. What is called pattern of utilization? The bacteria respiring or fermenting, depending on the diagnostic system, these can sources produce a pattern of utilizations. Whatever the sources the bacteria will use, there will be a pattern, there will be a perfect pattern of utilization that can be used to identify the bacteria. Okay, now we will understand about the biochemical kits. See, these kits are designed on the same principles as the conventional methods, such as the use of specific differential media will be used. This differential media will do what? They will allow the development of a particular microbes and biochemical test for the identification of bacteria. However, the format of test is modified. What is the modified format? These kits are made up of a disposable device containing an array of different media and substrates used for biochemical identification of bacteria. In these kits, what will happen? We use some disposable device containing an array of different types of media and substrates. Some media will be there and substrates will be there, which will be used for identification of bacteria. Okay, it will not be wrong to say that these are the miniature version of the biochemical test carried out conventionally for the identification of foodborne microbes, especially pathogens. These are small miniature version of the biochemical test carried out conventionally. These kits are commercially available and one does not have to go through the time consuming and cumbersome procedures of preparing the media and test reagents in the case of conventional method. That's why it is called rapid test technology. But the accuracy obtained with such kits are around 90 to 99%, although some test technology requires some incubation period of 24 hours. Okay, but the accuracy is what, 90 to 99%, not 100% accurately it will identify the culprit or bacteria causing foodborne illness. As compared to these are this 90 to 90% is as compared to conventional methods, these are 90 to 99% accurate. Okay, now it is automation is also developed for rapid detection methodology, in which we use some computer based technology to identify the phenotypic profile of the tested organisms, which is then matched with the computer database for identification purpose. Immunological methods. In immunological rapid test methods, what we do? We use highly specific antigen-antibody reactions and involve the use of monoclonal antibodies for detection of bacteria in the food samples. See, what is monoclonal antibodies? These antibodies recognize a single type of antigen. That's why they are called monoclonal antibodies. These methods comprise the largest group of methods used for detection purpose. The versatility and specificity of these reactions have prompted the production of immunological kits in various formats. So its versatility and specificity is very high. That's why we use this technology for making immunological kits. Latex agglutination assay. This involves the antibodies tagged with the colored latex beads or colloidal gold for the detection purposes. Then immunodiffusion format. This involves the diffusion of antigen through a gel impregnated with antibody. The appearance of the precipitation lines indicates the presence of specific antigens and is considered a positive test. Okay, so these two are there. Then ELISA, enzyme linked immunosorbent assay. In this technology of ELISA, we utilize antigen antibody reactions. The specificity of antigen antibody is utilized for detection of the pathogens. So in this, what we do? In a microtiter plate, what we take? We take the primary antibody in the microtiter, then we supply the food sample. If the food sample is having the particular antigen, then it will bind to the primary antibody. Then what will happen? We give the secondary antibody, which is having some enzyme, and this antibody will recognize the another part of the antigens. This antigen will be recognized by this antibody with some other epitope or other part. Then what we will do, we add some substrate, and this substrate will react with the enzymes and will give some color. If the color is present, then there is a positive result, and if the color is not developed, then there is absence of that particular microorganisms. But in this total process, there are two washing steps.
here once you have to do one washing step, and here one you have to do some washing step, so that the result will be perfect. The intensity of the color can also be measured by the help of ELISA reader. This intensity, when compared with the standard control, can be used for quantification of the antigen, or the result may be reported as positive and negative depending on the instruction given by the specific kit. Then immunoprecipitation, in this format the sandwich procedure is used, but it does not make use of any enzyme conjugated antibody for the detection of for the detection purposes. Instead, it relies on the antibody conjugated with the latex beads or colloidal gold for the detection purposes. These assays are simple and require no washings. In ELISA, we were using washing steps. That's why this step is not requiring any washing step. Immunomagnetic separation. In this, we utilize some specific antibodies which is coupled with magnetic particles. The specific bacteria bind to the antibody and is separated from the food matrix under the influence of some we use some magnetic field. And then we will separate the antibodies having some magnetic particles. It is very similar to enrichment using selective media. This enriched bacterial culture can then be detected by any of the rapid methods being discussed in this video. Okay.
Genetic methods for identification of microorganisms are based on the detection of the specific gene sequence in the genotype of the organisms. See, here we are targeting the specific gene sequence present in the genotype. Genotype means the profile of the genes. What is gene? Gene is the part of the DNA which can give a functional protein, that is called gene. And the gene sequence is not similar for all the organisms. Each person, each organism is having a specific gene sequence, and if we can target that particular gene sequence, then we can easily recognize that particular microorganisms. And these sequence may be selected to detect particular group, genus, species, or even strain of the microorganism. Suppose a kit has been developed for the detection of particular bacterial genus, then the DNA sequence occurring only in the members belonging to that genus is to be targeted. All these things are happening to avoid false negative reaction, and this sequence should not occur in other species belonging to the same genus. So the specificity of the detection process totally depends upon the targeted sequence. That is a target sequence, and we will recognize that target sequence to avoid the false negative reactions.
Presence of the specific gene is done by the help of PCR methods, that is called what? Polymerase chain reactions, in which we can target a specific genes which is involved in toxin production for the bacteria. Then nucleic acids probes. The principle behind this DNA probe is very simple, where we do what? Short single strands of DNA that are complementary to the gene present in a pathogenic microbes are synthesized. They are synthesized, and the food sample then be treated so that any microbial cells are lysed, releasing their DNA. Microbial DNA is then treated to convert it from double strand to single strands, and the probe is added. Then what happens? Hybridizations or annealing or joining of these two single stranded DNA are done, which is complementary to each other. Means complementary to each other means they can fix with each other's. Okay, and that occurs between the single stranded DNA probe and single stranded DNA released from the pathogenic microbes present in the food. Then probe DNA that has not hybridized must then be removed by the help of washing, and the presence of hybridized DNA probes can then be detected by the help of some UV rays. Okay, in this you can see what we have done. The stomach food sample we have taken, then we have done what enrichment of salmonella is done by the help of some selective media. Then what we have done, then we have lysed the cells and converted the double stranded DNA into a single stranded DNA. Then we have added to capture probe is captured, then detector probe is added. Then what annealing is done here, annealing is done, and this annealing is again detected with the help of some enzyme. At here, by the help of some color change, we can understand that there is a presence of the gene of Salmonella. The principal advantage of this system is the reduced time required for positive identification of Salmonella, and another advantage is the assay specificity. Okay, this is the advantage. Then polymerase chain reactions. This test is also based on the hybridizations of the oligonucleotide primer. This is important step. Oligonucleotide primer means some small stretch of primer which is complementary to the targeted DNA. And then what happens after the hybridizations or joining of this primer with the targeted DNA, then what happens? The amplification of the DNA, amplification means increasing the number of DNA into more stretch spanning this primer. So what happens, the main thing behind it is that this primer will target the specific sequence of that gene, and then the amplification of that particular gene will be done. If that targeted sequence is not there, then this primer will not join with that sequence, and what will happen? The amplification step will not happen, and hence we can understand that this gene is, or this particular DNA from that bacteria is not present. Suppose this one is the DNA strand. What we have done? We have denature this double strand DNA. Then what happens? The annealing of the primer is done at here, means joining of primer is done at here. Then this side and this side, then extension is happening here, so that the strand is formed, and there is amplification of the DNA is happened. But the main problem associated with the PCR technology is the ability of PCR to detect dead organism is a problem. So here we have to check. That can be avoided by the help of enrichment preceded by the PCR. But in some situations, the presence of live or dead pathogens is an important indicator for food safety. Then flow cytometry. The principle behind the flow cytometry is that it uses light scattering, light excitation, and emission of fluorochrome molecules to generate specific multi-parameter data from particles and cells in a size ranging from 0.5 micrometer to 40 micrometer in diameters. So what happens? The lasers are used to detect the cells which are having some fluorochrome inside it. By that, it can recognize the cells, and the pleurocytometry can also recognize living and dead cells. Here the sample core is given, and here the laser beam is given, and when the cell will move from this core, there will be some emission of light which will go to the data processor, and then from the data processor it will go to the display panels from which we can understand the type of cells. Okay, then impedance. By the help of impedance we can also recognize the microorganisms. So when microorganisms grow in a culture media, they metabolize the substrate and they will grow. And what will happen after metabolizing the substrate? The low conductivity substrates will be converted into higher conductivity and thereby decrease the impedance of the media. There exists an impedance of the media, means impedance is what? Resistance to the flow of electricity. So when the resistance is decreased, the impedance is also decreased in the media. Simple example include the conversion of glucose from a non-ionized substrate to two molecules of lactic acid with a corresponding increase of conductivity. So conductivity is increased as impedance is decreased. By this we can measure the impedance, how much impedance is decreased, how much impedance is reduced, that we can recognize. And by the help of recognize it, when the impedance of the growth culture is measured, the curves are reproducible for species and strains, and mixed cultures can be identified. This is our purpose to do this impedance technology. We have to identify the cultures, and by measuring the impedance we can calculate the, we can identify the cultures by the use of a specific growth inhibitors. There are also some use of growth inhibitors in this technology. Then biosensors. In this biosensors, what happens? We use some biological sensors, and that biological sensor is connected to a transducer. And this transducer is what? It is a device that is capable to convert signals from the biological sensors into one electrical signals that can be easily recognized and recorded and stored. For example, a number of biosensors use the specificity of the antibody antigen binding to detect pathogens in food sample. So antigen antibody binding can be recognized by the help of biosensors, which will be transduced by the help of transducers, and the signal is recognized, and we can understand there is some reaction between antigen and antibody. And if the antigen antibody reaction is happened, then we can easily recognize our bacterial sample, which is our main intention. So biosensors are of two types. One is affinity based biosensors, and another one is antibody based biosensors. So with this we have understood the rapid detection technology. Thank you a lot.